Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel startuplanes.com. I am Mohre Tanvi and as you know, these are the series of interviews that we are conducting for the promotion of some excellent startup across our country. Now the question is that why you should watch this interview? You should watch this interview if you are a job seeker. You should watch this interview if you want to invest. You should watch this interview if you want to know the merits and demerits of starting a new fresh business. Just remember one thing, experience is the best teacher. So let's jump into the interview and know some wonderful experiences from the CEOs and founders of various startups. Interview, we have Mr. Karthik from ICCPL with us. He is a former paramedic journalist and currently an assistant manager of research and report at ICCPL. Karthik is also the research head for ICCPL's research wing IBRF Global. He is an experienced news producer with a demonstrated history of working in the media and communications industry. Skilled in media relations, market research, strong media and communication professionals, Karthik holds a postgraduate diploma focused in radio and television from Indian Institute of Mass Communication, Delhi, affiliated to the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, Government of India. So let's know more about research specifically from Karthik. Good afternoon, sir. I am Mohre Tanvi from Startup Lanes. And we are really very grateful to have you on the board for this interview.
Thank you so much, Tanu.
Sir, I will please request you to introduce yourself to our viewers.
Okay, so Tanvi, my name is Karthik. I am a former paramedic journalist and I am currently working as an assistant manager, research and reports at ICCPL. I am also heading the research department for ICCPL, that is IBRF Global. I'm an experienced news producer with a demonstrated history of working in media and communications industry. I'm skilled in media relations and I hold a postgraduate diploma in radio and television journalism from the Indian Institute of Mass Communication, New Delhi. The college is affiliated to Ministry of Information and Broadcasting.
Yeah. So great. So just now you mentioned that you are the head of the research department. So I want to know that, what is the importance of research wing in media PR agencies?
When you talk about research, right? So people, obviously, to all our viewers who are watching up this video, I'll just make things very basic for them so that they can grasp each and everything what research is all about. Mm-hmm. If you try and Google what research actually means, so in Google you'll find that it's a form of action to get information, gather evidences for theories that can contribute to developing knowledge in a field of study. But I'll take you to the roots. Mm-hmm. What actually research is. So research basically is a tool for building knowledge and facilitating learning. It's a means to understand issues and increase public awareness. Research obviously helps in succeeding in businesses. It helps us to disapprove lies and support the truth that is out there in the market, or be it any sector or industry or whatsoever. It's a means to find the credibility of the source of information and seize opportunities, and it promotes a love and confidence in reading, writing, analyzing and sharing valuable information. And I believe each and every individual out there should read, should write and should analyze, because there will be chances where people will come up with their certain point of views and they can have a healthy discussion for it. And this is what research is all about. You come up with your own ideas, you try experimenting out with things, you try to dig in information, and this is how research works.
Okay. So thank you so much for explaining what exactly research is. Now I want to know that what are the issues or hindrances you face in the research area?
Okay, so the credibility of the information that we talk about, the credibility of the information and the source plays a very major role when it comes to research and research studies. There are several tools like for fact-checking and to understand the credibility of the source of the information. You can use Google Toolbox for that. You can go for factcheck.org, Truth or Fiction, Quality Fact, Snoops.com. These are few tools that are already available in the market to make your work really easy. But ideally, when you check the credibility of anything, be it an information, be it just a small source that is proving some certain facts and figures, you have to keep few things in mind before proceeding ahead with things. Firstly, you need to check with the credentials. You have to look out for biasness. When we talk about biasness, that you know, when you certainly read something on the web or even in your print media or in digital media or any source of information, can be books, can be radio or anything, you have to see whether that particular source of information doesn't lean towards a particular point of view. It shouldn't restrict itself to just one particular point of view. It should have their, you know, it should have no boundaries as such. So does it link to any sites? If you talk about articles, we have to see whether the articles seem to lean towards, like I said, a point of view. It links to different sites, files or images that can, you know, skew your ideology to left to right. This is how things are. And biased articles may not give you the entire gist of the story. So you will get a half-baked information, and just like a very famous phrase, a little knowledge is a dangerous thing. So you need to check out for biasness, then you can check out for dates, you can check out the source. When you talk about the source, obviously it's good to check them out, because officially when people, you know, associations, industries and people, they put out information out there on certain platforms, they are really biased think tanks that they have. And they will only present a very fringe point of view. And this can escalate to a large number of audience they cater to. So if you can't find sources, read as much as you can about the topic and, you know, decide for yourself whether this particular source of information that, you know, I am grasping is accurate or not. And there is a recent test called the CRAAP test that is available these days to, you know, check out your research, because obviously, when you talk about research, there will be a point of time where your information cannot be 100% true. So a CRAAP test is basically currency, relevance, accuracy, authority and purpose. So CRAAP test is basically used in the market these days to tackle out these big issues when it comes to research findings. Yes.
So thank you for enlightening us with the recent updates also. So the next thing I want to know, that as far as you are concerned, what has been your role so far in developing research ideas and carrying them forward?
Okay, so the role of every other researcher or head or people who are working in a research team is to eliminate the major flaws. When I talk about eliminating major flaws, they have to eliminate misinformation, incorrect facts, to keep the organization and the entire team from dire straits. Certainly, at this organization where I'm working currently, we take care of each and every facts and figures that we present in our stories that we do for our clients. We basically take care of them. So at major point of time, what happens is a certain number of reports that come out from different organizations or associations, they can have a certain amount of you can say glitches, incorrect facts and figures, the sample size are quite different. So we have to be quite careful while presenting our story ideas to the people out there who are doing stories for our clients. This is why we have to maintain a brand recall value for them. So this is how, you know, my role has been in this organization for developing research ideas and carrying them forward.
So till now you have explained what exactly research means, as in head, what are the rules and duties you have to perform. Now I want to know that how will this research wing of ICCPL, which you mentioned is known as IBRF Global, will help you achieve your long-term plans as an organization?
As long as you keep providing correct news and updates and other business models to the audience out there with precise facts and figures, your ship will sail. And we absolutely stand by this particular notion as an organization. Yes, at this ungodly hour, majority of times the news that is often shared on social media platforms, communication apps and media platforms are false. Their authenticity is quite questionable these days. And when I talk about, you know, authenticity of being questionable of certain facts and figures, I'm obviously talking about the vicious cycle of fake narratives and fake news that is spreading out there in the, you know, in our society at a very rapid pace. So I'll share few examples with you regarding the same. So recently, a lot of buzz has been created to what Afghanistan is going through due to Taliban takeover. So number of news escalated that, you know, Taliban people who have taken over the Afghan government over there, and, you know, they might go to an extent of creating a genocide. So number of news escalated that Talibans were wearing the United States military uniform. But later it was found that the video was about the Afghan army officials. It has nothing to do with Taliban's wearing US military uniforms or what. So it was about Afghan military officials. The entire video was about them. But certainly there are few people out there who spread out this video just to gain views, just to spread hate out there, who still believe that, you know, religious sentiments are something that can be triggered at any point of time. And there are people who are spreading such things. Similarly, a lot of people are promoting such things by photoshopping images of Afghan females tied to chains. But this is not what the real thing is. And several media organizations out there have done a quite research study about it. And later it was found that the entire, you can say the entire picture or the entire video that was being viral about this entire fact was completely false. Mm-hmm. So we need to carefully keep a watch and scrutinize things on the basis of credibility. It's not always about who breaks the news. I have been a former journalist. I have worked in the newsroom. I know that, you know, media organization, when they have to break the news, they want to be the first one to break the news. This is what the entire thing is about, because this is how they are going to gain their viewership. But what I have learned from my journalism experiences, it's not always about who breaks the news. It's about who breaks the news with accurate and precise information. And that's the most important thing out there.
So talking about the fake news and credibility, I want to know that in this pandemic situation, when everyone was at their home, we can't go out actually and find out what is the real incident. What were the challenges? And also you were talking about that we should take the information from credible sources. A few times it has happened that the renowned sources have also published some fake or not so real news. So at that situation, what we are supposed to do?
Okay, so there are going to be n number of challenges when you talk about media, when you talk about news, because you don't have one particular source, and people generally don't reveal their sources. When you talk about media publications, obviously, like I said, it's all about breaking the news first. So what they really do is they get a little gist of the information about the entire incident that has happened around that case, and they want to be the first one out there to break the news, because they want to gain their viewership. This is a very this is not the ideology that news media organizations and news platforms should do. You need to crack out information, because your job is to aware people what is happening in and around the world. Suppose if I am working in an organization, if I am working in a media house, my duty and my responsibility is to aware the citizens about whatever incidents, good or bad, have happened in the country or all across the globe with correct facts and figures. Because When you spread misinformation out there in the market, you have WhatsApp forwarded, you know, every day that comes to your mobile phone, and you go through an entire article. But the next day you realize that, no, this information was not really true. But you can see even the person who has sent you that WhatsApp messages, it's mentioned above that the message has been forwarded many times. But nobody really cares to, you know, open up the entire link, read about it, go on the web, do a research about it, that whatever the facts and figures of the incident that has happened in this particular state, city, country or whatsoever, is there is actually true or not. This is why you have to pull yourself back a little. You don't have to eat everything that the media is serving. You don't have to do that. There are people who are running media houses out there just to promote a propaganda. Right. So you just don't have to believe in everything. There is, like, humans are capable enough to do research. So this is why we are humans, right? We have the tendency to do things that are beyond imagination. We have been doing that. There was a time when India got independence and we couldn't even manufacture a needle. And now we are going to moon. This is what the technology has advanced. So this gives a privilege to the normal citizens also to go out on the web or any other platforms where they can dig out information. Just don't believe in everything that is being cooked by you. There can be chances whether these people are just spreading all these news just to, I'm not talking about the media houses as such, I'm talking about the people who are spreading fake news. Right, media houses and journalists have done a very fabulous job in this pandemic. They have been reporting, there have been people who have died also. When you talk about the journalism fraternity, Danish Siddiqui recently was murdered by the Taliban. And we have people like that. We have people like that in the media who are giving us great information. But as a citizen also, it's our responsibility to do a bit of a research before spreading out things, because this will lead to clashes. It can lead to communal violence. This can lead to things that are beyond your imagination, that is beyond your control. Because one thing that can trigger an entire community, we live in a community where people of each and every religion lives, right? We have to take care of each and every individual out there.
Mm-hmm.
This is what democracy is all about. This is what, you know, we talk, when we say media is the fourth pillar of democracy, yes, but try to maintain it. This is what my stance on this is.
Also, I advise that as a secular country, every sensible individual should, you know, make some research before forming an opinion.
Yes.
It could be about any particular thing, but at least have some basic knowledge from your side.
Like I'll continue with what you said. Opinions can be about anything.
Yeah.
My opinion about certain thing can be different from yours. My perception of, you know, understanding few things can be different of yours. But at the end of the day, when we sit together on a table and exchange our views, right? This is what will lead to a better understanding. This will let us help to know there will be certain facts and figures that I need. And there will be certain facts and figures that you know. And when we'll come across a table and we'll have a healthy discussion about it and we'll dig out information from various platforms that are available for us, we are going to, you know, cater much better audience with much better news with precise information. Mm-hmm. Yes.
And the information can't be extracted from WhatsApp University, to be very
honest. Yes. Yes. To be very honest. Yes. Yeah. Right.
Sir, lastly, I want to know that what do you think are the most significant research accomplishments?
Okay, so we here at ICCPL launched an in-house developed research team under the name of IBRF Global, like I told you. So we recently announced the first media mapping report for quarter one of financial year 2021 and 2022. The motive of the entire report was to help millions of not just PR professionals, marketing and communication heads, and the general audience to understand what media trends of the entire quarter have been.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So the report's focus was the shift in news coverages in the post-pandemic era, right? Whatever happened in the post-pandemic times and how it affected the percentage of coverage given to a particular beat. We have different beats when we talk about media. There is sports, there is politics, there is international relations, there is economy, public affairs, and so on, right? So the report's focus was mainly about the number of news coverages that were there in the post-pandemic times and how it affected the percentage of them when they were covered on different platforms, whether it was print, whether it was digital, whether it was the radio or any other platform, right? So when we talk about this, we, at the end of every month, we come out with a report about news trends, which flooded the print, television and other media modules to keep our audience and clients aware. So this IBRF Global, the in-house research team formed in ICCPL, will help each and every person out there, normal audience, the clients that we have, the PR professionals, the people who are working in the media fraternity, and others also who are interested to read, who are interested to know the correct facts, who are interested to know what is happening in their country or in their surroundings. And I feel really proud to say this, that ICCPL is one of the first PR agency which has its own research department now. And we have our own research team. Public relations agencies and firms and consultancies don't really have a research team because it's basically a B2B business. But we are trying to cater as many people as we can, not just with our business, but also being in the media, because we have media relations. We have liaising with people who are there in big organizations and media platforms. So we are trying to cater even the normal audience who don't have to do any business with us or anything to read our report, to get to know and be aware what has happened in the country in the past month. Yes.
So lastly, as you mentioned that every company and business should have a media research department. So I want to know that how important the research department is, like, you know, what will happen if there is no research department, because this department is not taken as that seriously as finance department or any other department.
Research obviously plays a very vital role, because you can write about anything. You can say the sky is pink, but it's actually not. In Delhi, as far as I know, as far as I have seen, there will be times where people can write that this person is the prime minister of the country, right? But he's not. That is the main point. This is why a research team is, capable enough and trained enough to get to know if there is any sense of misinformation that is being spread out in the market. We have to eliminate that. We do stories for our clients. We get them published in big media houses, because this is how PR agencies run, as I told you in our last interview. So as a PR agency and as a research team in a PR agency, our understanding about the entire scenario is we have to put out credible information. We can't just, because if you don't put out credible information, nobody is going to take you very seriously. Because there are thousands and not even thousands, there are lakhs and lakhs of media houses out there. There are lakhs of news portals out there where you can go and just read about things. Okay, this particular person has done an article about this particular incident, I should follow him, right? But you have a valid reason why you read about only certain publications and not all of them. Because you like their writing style, you like the fact that they address the truth, be it good, be it bad, and you are getting aware. So this is why I believe the research team plays a very vital role, because until and unless there is not going to be credible information, nobody is going to take you seriously. And when I talk about as a brand, ICCPL as a brand, we believe in spreading information that is credible, that is correct, that is precise, and doesn't harm the sentiments of the people. And I believe to make yourself a brand and to flourish yourself as a brand, research is very important.
Okay, sir. Sir, thank you so much for enlightening us. It was indeed a very fruitful session. Thank you so much, and have a very good day.
Thank you so much, Tanvi. Thank you.